Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to use Excel to determine exactly how much I'm going to need to invest each month to retire with $3 million. Okay, so yesterday I saw this article over at CNBC, and it looks like it's referencing a video over at NerdWallet, which basically is describing how much money you need to save each month at different age breakpoints in order to reach a goal of $3 million. Now, according to the article, they are making some assumptions here that we're going to get a return of about 6% annually, and we're also going to retire at age 67, and some here I saw on here that we're starting with zero. So, okay. So, let's see if we can't do this in Excel. So I've already started a little worksheet, and I'll provide the link to this down in the description, the video description. So basically, nothing too fancy in here. I set up columns, so I've got different ages, 20, 25, all the way up to 55, and 5-year intervals. Our big answer is going to show up here in these green cells. And I did create an area assuming that we're starting with zero, but we can change those numbers, you know. So maybe if you got a little in savings, we can see what the impact will be on that monthly requirement. Of course, we got the 6% in here, but we can change that. So if we want to change it to something else, we can. And retirement age of age 67, and we're going to be able to change that too to see if that is going to be a little bit more appropriate for your plans. But I do have the big goal in there. I've typed it up as $3 million. So the way we're going to do this is I'm going to work in this one cell for this 20-year-old. How much do they need to invest each month? I'm going to work in this one cell. And if we write our function properly, we can just fill it across and we'll get the answer for all the other age brackets. And I'm going to be using the PMT function for this. So let me go ahead and zoom in a little bit on my worksheet. Make it nice and big. I'm going to activate the cell that I want to do my primary work in. And I'm going to start off with the PMT function. So the PMT function has 5 different arguments, and we are going to be using all 5 of them in this. Actually, I take it back. We'll just be using 4. We don't really need to use the type argument here. But we're just going to go through it piece by piece using cell references and information where necessary. The first question, of course, it's asking me is the rate. What rate of return is this 20-year-old going to be getting? So what I'm going to do is click on the cell that contains the 6% annual rate of return and divide it by 12 to get a monthly rate of return, comma. The next field is the number of payment periods. Basically, this is going to be the number of investment months that this person has until they're age 67. This is going to require just a little bit of calculation. I'm going to put in a set of parentheses, an opening parentheses. I'm going to take the 20-year-old's retirement age, which in my case is in cell B6, age 67, minus their current age of 20. I'm going to take that result and I'm going to multiply it by 12 and then a comma. So to understand what's going on here is basically I'm taking 67 minus 20 to get 47, and I'm multiplying that by 12 to find out how many months there are in total for the 47 years. Now, you don't want to do the math in your head. You want to rely on your cell references. So that way, when we copy this formula over, it's going to be accurate for all the other ages, and it's still going to be accurate if we change our retirement age and things like that. Now the next argument I need to put in is present value. Now this is going to be the cell that contains how much money you're starting with. It's basically zero, so I could have skipped this one, comma. And then the future value. This is ultimately my goal. So I'm going to click on the cell that contains the big $3 million, and I'm going to press my F4 key in order to make that an absolute reference, because all of my formulas are going to reference this same goal cell. So there's a lot going on in here, so let me just do another quick recap. The rate of return is the cell that contains my annual rate of return divided by 12. That gets me a monthly rate of return, monthly compounding. The number of periods is basically the number of years the person has until retirement times 12. That'll determine how many months we have until retirement. I'm taking the retirement age minus the current age and multiplying that by 12. The present value is going to refer to the cell that contains how much money I already have invested in the account. So we're going with the initial assumption of zero, but we'll be able to change this easily later on. And then my future value is the cell that contains my retirement goal amount of $3 million. When I press enter, I can see, oh, I'm getting a negative. Let me do one quick fix here. I'm going to put a minus sign in front of my future value, so this will display as a positive. So basically, a 20-year-old is going to need $958 savings per month at 6% in order to get to that $3 million goal at age 67. I'm going to take this formula and move it all the way across, and we can start to see other amounts. For instance, a 30-year-old would need to invest over $1,800 a month. And if I jump back to that article real quick, on their video, that's where I paused it. 30-year-old would need $1,839 in order to get to that $3 million. So there you go. So there's our pretty nifty calculator. Now, of course, if this is more, you know, if this is going to be for you, then you can put in numbers that seem a little bit more realistic. For instance, maybe you would be quite satisfied with $2 million. Now, of course, if that's your goal, that's certainly going to impact your monthly investment requirements. And maybe you are feeling more like you could do better than 6%. Maybe you're thinking 7.5% is reasonable. Let me show a decimal on these. And if you get a higher average annual rate of return, that will also lower your monthly investment requirements. So there you go. You can play around with the spreadsheet that I've linked in the video description, or you can create your own pretty easily just by using that PMT function.